Welcome, everyone. Please stand, and gentlemen, please remove your caps for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. Please remain standing and join in the singing of our national anthem and alma mater, as led by the Queensbury High School Combined Bands and Orchestras under the direction of Mr. James Cirillo, and the Madrigal Singers under the direction of Mr. Matthew Gollin. Welcome, fellow classmates, educators, family, and friends. I want to thank you all for giving me the opportunity to speak at such an important event in all of our lives. However, I must confess, the real reason I'm here today is that our class president, Tyler Spalding, is starting his cadet training at the United States Air Force Academy. Tyler, we know you will do us proud. And as for all of you, you are stuck with me this evening. Tonight, we will reflect on the 13-year journey that led to this moment. On behalf of the class of 2022, I want to recognize the people who have supported us along the way. We are grateful for the time, dedication, and investment you took in our futures. Specifically, the following people we want to give our utmost thanks. Our graduating class would like to thank our families. Your support and guidance has turned us into who we are today. To our teachers, who went above and beyond to educate us, thank you for spending your time, knowledge, and patience with us each and every day, which I know could not have been easy. To our coaches and advisors, thank you for enriching our lives beyond the classroom. This investment taught us lessons we will carry through adulthood. To our custodial staff, nurse, and lunchroom attendants, your tireless efforts in keeping the school clean and safe meant that we could enjoy in-person learning, and for that, we will forever be grateful. To our administration and office staff, thank you for keeping things running smoothly behind the scenes. We know the stress that you have been under, but your commitment to our school is to be commended. To our school counselors, thank you for listening, supporting, and providing guidance to all of us in planning for the next stage in life. The diversity of our needs certainly must have been difficult to balance. On behalf of the class of 2022, I would also like to extend a huge thank you to our class advisors, Mrs. Carrie Rodriguez and Mrs. Jessica Donnelly. Throughout our 4 years at Queensbury High School, you have diligently worked to support our planning of our class events and ensure we all had an enjoyable experience. You never gave up on our dream for a high school prom, and the evening succeeded our expectations. We are so thankful and appreciative of the investment you made in our class. Lastly, I want to thank you, class of 2022, for giving me the opportunity to be your vice president. It has truly been an honor. Congratulations, we finally did it. And now, I have the honor of announcing the class of 2022's parting gift. This year, our remaining funds will go towards beginning a scholarship in Adam Sweeney's name. This fund is graciously given in remembrance of one of our own, Adam Sweeney. Those who knew Adam will remember him for his humor, constant warmth, happiness, and loving nature. This scholarship will celebrate future Queensbury Spartans who are pursuing a degree in special education, encapsulates a true love of life, and possesses a kind and open heart, much like that of Adam. At this point, we would like to invite members of the Sweeney family to accept Adam's honorary diploma.
As president of the National Honor Society, I'm honored to introduce our esteemed high school principal, Mr. Damian Switzer. As a role model for us all, his dedicated and passionate educational leadership style will be fondly remembered, and we wish him well in retirement. With pleasure, I present to you, Mr. Switzer.
Thank you, Isabella. Good evening and welcome, parents, family members, fellow educators, members of the Board of Education, and most importantly, the class of 2022 to the 70th annual graduation commencement ceremony for Queensbury High School. I'm grateful we have the opportunity to celebrate this moment together in person, where you can feel the energy and excitement of a commencement celebration that acknowledges your accomplishments as a class. We've been through a lot together over the years, and tonight's ceremony is no different, as it marks the beginning of a new pathway for both you and me as we prepare to start the next chapter of our lives. Our Spartan pride is alive and well, and I'm confident that it will occupy a special place in our hearts for many years to come. Parents, grandparents, friends, supporters, and virtual guests, it's my sincere pleasure to present to you the 262 graduating members of the class of 2022. on behalf of Superintendent Gannon, the Board of Education, and the entire staff of the Queensbury Union Free School District, I say congratulations for a job well done to an outstanding group of young adults sitting before us who finished their Queensbury academic careers tonight. There are several people I would like to recognize this evening who have played a significant role throughout the high school careers of the seniors. Once again, thank you to Mrs. Carrie Rodriguez and Mrs. Jessica Donnelly, who never stopped working on your behalf. They worked tirelessly to organize senior events and community service projects to bring you together as a class. Over the last 4 years, Mrs. Rodriguez and Mrs. Donnelly provided the energy, enthusiasm, patience, and leadership that this class has greatly appreciated. Thank you both for your guidance and support. I would also like to recognize and congratulate two retiring members of the high school faculty who have a combined 56 years of dedicated service to the students and community of Queensbury and over 70 years total in education. To Mr. Kevin Sullivan and Mrs. Karen Bauer, thank you for your commitment to our students. Your hard work and dedication is a special gift, and you will all be missed very much. I would also like to thank and congratulate Mr. Daniel Hamm, who has accepted an administrative position in Hadley-Luzerne as the junior-senior high school principal. And finally, congratulations to Mr. Andrew Snide, who has been appointed as the next Queensbury High School principal. How about a big round of applause for my dream team? Both Mr. Sullivan and Mrs. Bauer shared their insights with me regarding their longevity as educators. Love what you do and do what you love. That's not to say that there won't be challenges ahead of you. Rather, it implies that when you love your work, it feels like a choice more than a burden. On the whole, it adds value and meaning to your life and fills your soul rather than saps it of vitality. Find an element of fun in your career, no matter what the challenge. Mrs. Bauer shared, "Working with my students brings me joy." Mr. Sullivan shared, "Talking and laughing with kids every day, setting goals, making lists, getting things done, seeing myself as a public servant. I never really saw this as work, but rather my calling, destiny, or mission. I feel exactly the same way. Some have asked me if I've been counting down the days until retirement, but for me, it's been more like savoring every moment. Queensbury has been my home for 20 out of my 34 years in education. Every day has been like a package waiting to be opened with wonder and excitement. The contents of the package were not always what I was expecting, but that never dimmed my hope or excitement. I will always look fondly on my time here and hold this district in the highest regard. Serving as your principal will always be one of the highlights of my career. Your career pathway is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. Don't settle. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. And like any great relationship, it just gets better and better as the years roll on. Your class president, Tyler Spaulding, and classmate Bridget Duffy found their career pathways through military service and a demonstrated passion for service and leadership. As you know, Tyler was called to duty at the United States Air Force Academy and couldn't be here today. He plans to play baseball for Air Force and become a pilot. He said to me, "Serving my country is something that I hold in high regard." Bridget accepted an appointment to the United States Military Academy at West Point, where she'll play both soccer and lacrosse.
She'll be following in the footsteps of her dad and mom, who's also a West Point graduate. She told me she fell in love with the West Point campus, the emphasis on leadership, service to our country, and the honor that it holds. Giovanni Vanderveer developed a passion for culinary arts at a young age. He was inspired by his grandmother, who worked long hours, but still found the time to make incredible family meals. Gio would flash that big smile every time one of us would ask about what he prepared with the chef that day. He loved his CTE program and the cooking club. Gio plans to serve in the United States Marine Corps like his dad and be a food service specialist, preparing food for hundreds at a time. "I take pride in what I do," he said. Gio plans to travel the world and run his own restaurant someday. His enthusiasm was apparent every day, and we looked forward to the treats he would bring back to share with his favorite administrative team. As your principal, I couldn't be more proud of this entire senior class. You entered high school in the midst of a building project, persevered through almost 2 years of a global pandemic, and adjusted back to full in-person learning. As the masks finally came off, how great was it to finally see everyone's smiling faces for the first time? Your class demonstrated leadership, scholarship, and devotion to community service. You served as positive role models in our school. We remember your academic achievements, the dedication and the sportsmanship of our athletes, the girls' varsity lacrosse team, showing us they had the right stuff to make it all the way to the state finals, and Dylan Shell, our state champion in wrestling. Wow. Let's not forget the accomplishments of our music department with outstanding performances that finally filled our newly renovated auditorium and brought us together as a school community. These are achievements and memories that will always be part of your legacy as a class. As you reflect on your school career and contemplate your future goals and dreams, and as I reflect on my own career, the message that I cherish most, love what you do, is a lesson that I learned from my father and one that he shared with me and my classmates during my sixth grade moving up day graduation ceremony many, many, many years ago. And as a dad, I've also shared this message with my own family, so I'd like to share this brief, very brief story with all of you. My dad was an educator, administrator, an advocate for individuals with disabilities, and a pioneer in vocational rehabilitation. He was also physically challenged with mild cerebral palsy that handicapped the right side of his body. Needless to say, this was an obstacle, but I've never met a person who could do more than he could. With his disability, he took great pride in accomplishing what would be relatively simple for the average person. He whitewater rafted in the Grand Canyon, rode in a nuclear submarine during training exercises, played the piano, and could beat any challenger at ping pong. He boogie boarded in the ocean on Cape Cod, was headmaster of one of the first schools in the nation to provide education for children with disabilities, and he managed to befriend each and every person he met. So at my sixth grade moving up day graduation ceremony, this is what I remember. My dad boldly walked up to the stage, turned his back on the audience, pulled the microphone from the podium, and addressed only the students. With his good hand, he showed the class a sign language symbol with his thumb, index finger, and pinky. Why don't you try this with me? Just your thumb, index finger, and pinky. Does anyone know what this means? In American Sign Language, this is the symbol for love. Dad said, "This is all you need to get through in life, love. Make this your superpower." Everybody has some kind of passion, and if you can find it, work at it. The only way to do great things is to love what you do. Now, this story is very personal to me, but speaks an invaluable truth. Go through life with love, and you will achieve your goals and dreams. By no means does love make you soft or weak. Going through life embracing love makes you a strong, independent, compassionate, humble, and hardworking person. So how can you go through life with love? The answer is simple, but sometimes challenging to practice. You must love what you do. If you love what you do and it's making you happy, all the hard work and perseverance will pay off. When you know you've truly given it your all, there's no greater feeling in the world. Passion is what drives you to accomplish great things. You must love your family and friends. They are your support system, and they are the ones that keep you going in times of adversity. Finally, love a challenge. Life is full of unforeseen challenges and obstacles. Know that with the love and support of your family, friends, relatives, and this entire school community, anything is possible. As you look to the future, savor every moment. Make every day like a giant package to be unwrapped with wonder and excitement. Congratulations to the class of 2022. Thank you.
As the president of the Student Senate, it is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Daniel Hamm, assistant principal, who will present the Outstanding Academic Achievement Awards.
Thank you, Blake. At this time, I would like to announce the recipients of the 2022 Queensbury High School Outstanding Achievement Awards. Alyssa Carson will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Art to Milo Tverdic. Sarah Hogan Gauchi will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Business Education to Miriam Blankenship. Lucy Prosco will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in English to Blake Powers. Victoria Fenichel will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in French to Rachel Beth Mannix. Tim Kayampa will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Mathematics to Isabella Robleski. Gregory Verheyen will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Music to Lindsay Bauer. Amanda Bangle will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in New Media to Jack Mahaney. Doug Frazier will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Physical Education to Riley Harris Burke. Marnie DeJean will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Science to Julia Afsar Kashmiri. Carrie Rodriguez will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Social Studies to Jack Sturman. Sue Sanchez will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Spanish to Rachel Beth Mannix. Colleen Sprague will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Student Services to Andrew Cooper. Ben Grieco will present the Outstanding Achievement Award in Technology to Lucas Powell. Congratulations, everyone.
Good evening, everyone. As Vice President of the National Honor Society, it is my pleasure to introduce Karina Myers, a member of the class of 2022, who will share her commencement address.
Congratulations, class of 2022. We made it. Earning your diplomas and special recognitions is a mark of your dedication and perseverance toward your goals. Certainly, we recall the events of Friday, March 13th, 2020, spring of our sophomore year. At that time, we couldn't imagine that for almost 18 months, our school life would include Google Meets, masked faces, quarantines, and cancellations of all our favorite activities. Turning off the computers, checking out, and giving up would have been easy. Instead, you all stuck with it. You found new ways to engage, and you discovered unknown talents and interests, withstanding a worldwide pandemic with resilience. As I prepared for this address, I wondered, from where does the source of this type of tenacity come? I recalled joining the Queensbury community as a kindergarten student in Mrs. Cassavant's class. That, too, was a scary time. We separated from a known comfort. Then it was home, now it is our familiar QHS. Yet, while venturing onto paths unknown, we felt excited about the possibilities awaiting us. As our confidence grew and our minds expanded with new knowledge, we developed the skills to keep on keeping on, even when presented with challenges. I'm reminded of Robert Fulghum's book, All I Really Needed to Know, I Learned in Kindergarten. I encourage you to explore this text and ponder how much we actually learned at those tiny tables in kindergarten. Life lessons like share everything, don't hit people, and my personal favorite, take a nap every afternoon. It occurred to me that since so many great lessons grew from our early beginnings, perhaps more wisdom awaited there. After reconnecting with Mrs. Cassavant, I visited her class to speak with the members of the class of 2035 and ask them what advice they would give us. Here's what they said. The first student I interviewed said to go on a vacation and relax. Sounds like a great idea. I bet many of you have scheduled trips to celebrate your achievements, but let's take this advice a step further than Disney World. Getting tangled in the overwhelming pressures of adult life, as we know we will, is inevitable. When this happens, breathe. Read a book, go on a hike, enjoy coffee with a friend, binge watch your favorite show. Clearing your mind and calming your thoughts will enable you to return to work feeling refreshed. Secondly, I was told to make new friends. Isn't life easier with a friend by your side? Wherever you find yourself, reach out to new people. Each person's values, heritage, and worldview provide new perspectives, introducing you to new philosophies, cultures, and ideas. Through their example, sometimes good and sometimes not so good, you discover who and what you want to become. The next student I encountered probably had educators as parents because he advised to do your homework. Most likely, he was referring to the all too familiar homework we know, which obviously is a major component of any academic degree, but let's consider other applications. Before making a decision, think wisely. Weigh the potential consequences of your actions. When presented with a controversial topic, research both sides, checking sources for accuracy and validity. Most importantly, if doing your homework proves that you were wrong, don't be too proud to admit that and learn from your mistake. Next came the advice to take pictures. How many of you have a relative constantly with a camera or phone in hand photographing all your games, concerts, and celebrations? I'll guess that more than once this annoyed you. It may have even happened today. But now, with our childhoods ending, aren't you grateful for those captured memories pasted on graduation displays? Time moves faster when you're mid-experience, so don't forget to live within that moment. Don't be so busy preparing for something that it's over before you enjoy it. Take a minute to take a picture, even if it's just in your mind. The children offered strong opinions on the best careers. Chloe informed me that she would pursue the best job, a scientist, and a ballerina. While these two interests seem vastly different, this underscores the need to develop a skill set which facilitates growth in many directions. Tommy was quite practical, saying, get a job and make lots of money. Of course, financial security is everyone's dream, but equally important is finding a job that allows you to build a life, not just a living. As my grandfather frequently stated, find a job you love and you'll never work a day in your life. Finally, Emma proudly proclaimed, I have a grandpa, and he used to protect a war to save the earth. If your post-grad plan includes military service, thank you for your dedication for our country. Because of you, we enjoy the freedom of choosing our own paths in a country with countless opportunities. Many of the children shared a common answer when I asked them for advice, simply saying, I don't know. On a side note, one asked for my number so he could text me his answer later. I think it's safe to say that he'll survive high school with no issues with low self-confidence. Truthfully, though, none of us really know what the future holds. Sometimes the path twists into a maze and we become uncertain, but that's when we apply all the lessons learned through the years. Our experience builds determination to stay the course, or we pick a different route to try again. Uncertain times call for faith, hope, and flexibility. And now the comment that touched me the most. You'll say bye to your teacher, and you'll say bye to your class, and they'll say goodbye to you. It struck me that this ceremony is the first time in 2 years, and likely the last time that we will all be together. While we may not see each other as often after today's graduation, our shared time at QHS will forever unite us. So, class of 2022, go make friends, see the world, do your homework, take lots of pictures, create a life you want to live, but mostly enjoy the journey and never forget where it all began. Congratulations.
The Madrigal Singers will present the next song under the direction of Mr. Matthew Gollin. The piece, Annie Laurie, shares the idea that the most important things in life are worth working hard for.
Mm-hmm. swells and sprays are bonny, where early falls the dew. And 'twas there that Annie Laurie gave me her promise true. Gave me her promise true, which ne'er forgot will be. And for Bonnie Annie Laurie, I lay me to and thee. Her brow is like the snowdrift, her throat is like the swan, her face it is a fair.
It is my pleasure to introduce our next speaker from the class of 2022. Rachel Beth Mannix will now share her commencement remarks.
There goes a story in which a man took 10 years to travel home. He faced many trials and tribulations, from being blown off course numerous times to encountering the dangerous monster Scylla, and he lost some people along the way, but eventually he made it back home. And while he traveled, his family waited for him, confident that he would one day return. His name was Odysseus, and this is the story of his Odyssey, which many of us are somewhat familiar with, even if we don't remember much. Though Homer's language might be difficult to understand, the notion of an odyssey is not. High school has been our odyssey. We entered as young freshmen, excited to start the next adventure. After all, after hearing so many interesting stories, we wanted to experience everything for ourselves. And after the battle of middle school, we felt we were certainly prepared for a smooth sailing through high school. We would easily find our way home, our way to normalcy and routine, our path to the future. But just as with Odysseus, fate decreed otherwise. We didn't even get to start with an easy journey. Instead, we were thrown into the churning waters that was the high school in the middle of the Legacy 2020 project. I'm sure we all remember that winter in a school with cardboard walls and concrete floors. I remember my friends and I brought hand warmers to school most days, and I saw students walking around with blankets. It wasn't a fun winter or school year with all the noise and frigid temperatures, but it brought us together, even if in the small way that we needed to stick together for warmth. We shared our blankets and hand warmers and joked about everything to keep our morale up, and we got through it together. We came out of that year with a new high school and a new mindset that we could survive anything. So we started 10th grade. Everything was great. We had real walls and floors and a brand new high school that looked more like a college. It was exactly what we wanted high school to be. And then COVID. Felt like we were cursed, like how Odysseus thought he was cursed by the gods. We would think we were getting back to normal, and then bam, more lockdowns. You don't need me to tell you how bad COVID was, though. You already know. But hey, here we are, maskless and graduating in a live ceremony, not a computer in sight. I know I, for one, have seen enough Google Meets and Zooms to last a lifetime. COVID was just another obstacle, an almost two-year one, in our odyssey. We were forced to navigate a brand new circumstance, unprecedented by everyone, even the United States government. But we survived and found ways to thrive. Again, we were able to use some humor to get us through the endless, ever-changing rules and regulations. Like Odysseus, we never lost hope, even when the world seemed dead set against us. We were determined to get home, to reach normalcy. We also faced many temptations, just as Odysseus did. He had sirens and Circe who tried to lure him into traps, but he battled through. We had our own temptations, social media and the force of peer pressure. I am proud to say that we persevered through these temptations. At times, it might have been difficult, and sometimes we might have succumbed, but we found our way out. We have made mistakes. We're teenagers, it's in our nature. But I also believe that we have learned from those mistakes. Experience helps us grow and change, for the better and for the worse, though I personally choose to believe that we have changed for the better as we enter adulthood. Odysseus also lost many men on his journey, and unfortunately, our odyssey has also had moments of great loss. This year, we lost Adam Sweeney, one of our valuable classmates. We also lost Mrs. Bennett, one of our valuable teachers. Their smiles and laughter will be greatly missed around the halls of Queensbury. We may mourn, but we must also remember and keep pushing forward. In their memory, let us continue persevering through every obstacle and find ways to thrive in the world around us. Now, as we stand on the cusp of our last odyssey and our new one, we don't know what will happen next. We face many of the same fears as we did before, but we should all now know that we are far stronger than we know. If we are Odysseus, and we will always find our way back home.
As president of the National Honor Society, I am honored to introduce our superintendent of schools, Mr. Kyle Gannon.
Board of Education members, parents, grandparents, and family members, and most importantly, the class of 2022. This past month, I was able to attend my son's college graduation ceremony. I saw a quote that a graduate was holding that said, "I don't know where I'm going." I truly was touched by that quote. Empathy raced through my mind. I remember when I was in the auditorium in my high school, ready to head off to college, I truly did not know what was going to happen with my life. In essence, I really did not know where I was going. Then, before I knew it, 4 years flew by, and then I was graduating with a bachelor's degree. I had a decision to make. What was my next step? I didn't have any job opportunities yet. I still couldn't quite go home. So I began my master's degree. I still really didn't know where I was going. As I approached finishing my master's degree, I ran out of money, and I had racked up a scary amount of student loan debt. I remember sitting in my apartment wishing I knew the answers to the questions I had asked myself since high school graduation. Where am I going? What are my next steps? I had no idea. I had to move home. After I moved home, I was eager to get my life started. I was 22 years old living with my parents. I am pretty sure that was not good for either of us. I was fortunate enough to interview at Queensbury and be hired as a third grade teacher in 1996. So the phrase, I don't know where I'm going, but I sure know where I've been, ties into two things tonight. First, I want to play a short clip for you that I think really ties together these sentiments. Think back with me on where you've been these past years. Then we will try to tackle the biggest question we all have. Where am I going? By trying to tie together all the experiences we have had at Queensbury during your time here. Here comes the clip. Listen up.
The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by. The music has been muted for copyright purposes. Please stand by.
Just so everyone knows, that couldn't be sent via live stream, so our friends couldn't hear that. But anyways, I know many of the parents would like me to finish that clip. As you return from that exhilarating song, I bring you to Queensbury Elementary School in the year 2009. 211 students out of the class of 262 entered Queensbury Elementary School that year and today are sitting out here among the graduating ranks. Here are some things your peers remember from their Queensbury Elementary career. Dan Irwin said, I remember field days. Chase Freed remembers the school-wide art show. Cassidy Ray recalls playing parachute in the gym. Andy Thatcher has memories of playing the recorder in third grade. So do your parents, Andy. So do your parents. Lorelei Lorador remembered her favorite teacher, Mrs. Vandewalker, for being there to help her whenever she needed. A few more memories stuck out to me about those times as well. Grandparents' breakfast, 100th day celebration, spirit days. Most importantly, I remember long lunch lines and hungry kids as you learned your PIN numbers. At the WHBI, 14 more of your students joined the rank, making the total 225. New memories were made at the WHBI. Peyton Mihalik remembers how Mrs. Fazio's mom, Mama Faz, would come into school and bake for us. Lucas Spire remembers building a fort in Mr. Henderson's fourth grade classroom. I made him take that down, by the way. Joe Sumner liked playing wall ball behind the WHBI. McKenna Keys remembers air band. She remembers being able to dress up as Pitbull and wear a bald cap. This was one of her favorite memories, also having so much fun with her friends. Sophia Chapa loved PLR. Cassandra Potter's favorite memory was starting to play viola in grade 5. Terry Ide remembers a really good reading grade in grade 5 that he received, like a V or something. Jack Mahaney remembers movie Fridays in the lunchroom in Mrs. Burton's class in 5th grade. Natalie DeJean remembers Mrs. Wakarik and how much fun she made 4th grade. Natalie said, I've known her for a while beforehand, so she got to see me grow up to become a senior. I remember a few moments too. Let your dreams fly at the WHBI. pizza for lunch? Do you remember some of you spending your Friday nights at West Mountain? Spartitude, the school-wide spelling bee? At QMS, 23 more students joined your class, making the total 248 out of 262. More memories were made. Caitlin Berger loved going to all the dances. Tyler Harrington liked the seventh grade field trip to Boston. All right. I should have thought about this speech, huh? Rachel Beth Mannix enjoyed her writing class in sixth grade and English class in seventh grade. She says, I just really enjoyed all the writing and the poetry that we did in the two classes with Miss Buss and Miss Serber. They were awesome teachers. Those two classes really helped build my love for writing. However, an honorable mention goes to French class with Mrs. Pierce in seventh and eighth grade. Luke Buckingham remembers his first dance. Mackenzie Gertson's favorite memory of middle school is getting into the select show choir. Alexis Rogers loved Mrs. Bennett's ELA class. Delaney Donahue says, studio art in eighth grade with Mrs. V was the highlight of my day. Lauren Nelson remembers Six Flags New England trip with the Chamber Orchestra. Do-Rin Chang said his favorite middle school memory was the cooking unit in Mrs. Zolke's seventh grade class. I remember a few too. Seven down, six to go. Career cruising. You paved the way for one-to-one Chromebooks with our school district. You started the student help desk. The middle school's talent show. Remember watching your teachers on stage? Now that was awesome. Opening the creation lab. Having a blast at carnival night. And of course, there were plenty more band, orchestra, and chorus concerts. When you finally reached Queensbury High School, 14 more students joined your class, rounding out the number to 262. Memories were made. Brianna Winch enjoyed photography class. She said it allowed people to be creative and go on fun field trips. Brianna Gay remembers Mr. Burns, the grand poopah. He has such a passion and a love for teaching that you see every day. She has never seen anyone so energized for a first block AP microeconomics class. He wants each and every person to succeed and seeks to build relationships with his students. Anna Schuett said, I've made such good friends and memories throughout high school. Stephen Deutsch remembers Coach Williams and the life lessons he had given him throughout hockey. Andrew Del Signor remembers Mrs. Donnelly and the Yellowstone trip with the biology class. Lucas Longitano remembers Miss Britt and her kindness. Jacob Johnston's favorite memory is winning the Tennis Foothills Championship. Miriam Blankenship recognizes Mr. Don Lippa. She says physics is a very hard topic to study, and through Mr. Lippa's different anecdotes and fun in-class activities, I was able to enjoy physics while improving my abilities, even when I struggled. Mr. Lippa always enjoys helping his students and watching them improve in their physics abilities. Jenna Reppenhagen's favorite memory is going to Disney World with the Chamber Orchestra. I remember a few too. Freshman orientation. Picking a pathway for yourself. Club events, such as Sidewalk Chalk and helping our snack pack program. Concerts, sporting events, going through a building project while being in the building. You heard a part of the song at the beginning of this that said, I don't know where I'm going. However, you sure know where you've been. You have been with a group of people that care about you. You know where you've been. Queensbury is a place where I've been able to call home. Queensbury is a place where you've been able to call home. Home sweet home. You may not know where you are going, but you will always be able to come home to Queensbury, a place where you sure have been. You will always be welcome here. Who knows? Maybe you'll end up opening a business here, maybe working in our community, or better yet, maybe at the Queensbury Union Free School District. I wish each and every one of you the best. I'm proud of each and every one of you.
It is now with the utmost respect and gratitude that I'm able to introduce our honorary faculty speaker, Coach Frazier. Whether it's hitting the rock with the sisters and brothers of the cages, playing basketball in the Shrine, or just being an energetic health teacher, Coach Frazier presents a larger-than-life personality that I think everyone here at Queensbury knows and loves. So please give a warm welcome to Coach Doug Frazier.
For some reason, I have to lift the microphone up. Magic powers. The Minister of Defense, the water bug of the cages, I cannot think of a better person to introduce me tonight for this honor than Blake Magic Power. So thanks, Blake. I appreciate that. Good evening, family, friends, colleagues, and the students, of course. Congratulations to your support teams up in the stands. And enjoy this moment. This is what it's all about. I would like to start off by saying a few weeks ago, four amazing student leaders came to see me. And it was such a big surprise. I'm certainly not worthy. Lex, Big A, I know you're out there somewhere. T, who's, as we know, is not here, and Jude. And they asked if I'd be willing to speak tonight. And of course, it was a no-brainer. Of course I would. It's an honor to be here. And apparently, I'm assuming Oprah and Michael Jordan were busy tonight, so you guys get me. So I'll make the most of it. I did ask, why me? And sometimes you gotta be careful as to what you ask. And in this case, all four student leaders came back to me and they said, well, Coach, we were given the advice to find somebody at the end of their career or retiring. And I paused and looked at him and I said, well, I definitely looked the part, but I got a few years to go yet. At least I hope. I wanted to begin tonight by telling you a story about three former Queensbury High School graduates, very close friends of mine. Mark Benign, George Murphy, and yes, Doug Frazier. That's right, I'm a 1984 graduate. Shocking, I know, maybe you're thinking 2004, but yeah, 1984. I always knew I wanted to teach and coach when I was your age, thanks to people like the man on my right, Coach Cabana, and I know that Coach Danette, I believe, is up in the stands tonight. It's because of you guys who motivated me. I feel fortunate to do both. I love what I do. But besides that, in my wildest dreams, I would not think that I'd be a keynote speaker at a Queensbury High School commencement tonight. In my wildest dreams, no way. And I'm sure some of my teachers would probably feel the same way. But there is hope, because if you're a C student, throw in a couple D's maybe, you could be a keynote speaker too. Woo! Yes, indeed. Let's just say my report cards never made it to the refrigerator at 7 Pinewood Avenue. All right. The next Queensbury graduate I would like to talk about is Mark Benign. And I'm sure there's a few people in the stands right now with a smile on their face. Mark always wanted to work in the NFL. That was always his dream. He started his career off at an unfulfilling computer information systems job at Syracuse University for 2 years. Instead of staying in a career that he found very disappointing, he continued to search for a more meaningful career and position. Through his hard work and perseverance, Mark has accomplished his goal and is now the Vice President of Marketing for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. That's right. It wasn't easy, nor is anything worthwhile or good in life easy. But Mark had to go through a lot to get there, and he did it.
Never underestimate your dreams, graduates. Never, never, and always pursue your passion. Don't let anybody get in the way of that. The last Queensbury graduate I'd like to talk about is a 50-year relationship and my best friend. I get choked up talking about it because we were sitting right next to each other 38 years ago. His name is George Murphy, AKA Murph. Always wanted to be successful in the business world. And currently, he is the CEO of Safety Insurance in Boston, Massachusetts. And may I say, a millionaire. Like, very wealthy for a good reason. He's a good friend to have. But I believe, and this is all about relationships if you haven't figured it out, I believe that the majority of his success was and is a direct result of his character and his ability to connect with others. Not only is he empathetic, but also perceptive and sensitive to those who he encounters. It doesn't matter who you are. One of the most sincere forms of respect is actually listening to what someone else has to say. And Murph does it better than anybody I've known. Which leads me to my final message tonight. I have had to overcome so many struggles in my own life. As I know all of you in the audience tonight, we've all had to endure, including the graduates. We all share that common bond as human beings to have to overcome and endure challenges in our lives. My last example of inspiration is emotional for me. It's very hard to talk about tonight. I had to get permission from somebody who I love very much. I would like to share a personal experience I had with my son's cardiologist, Dr. Jonathan Rhodes. My wife and I found out very early on that we were having twins and that we were having a boy and a girl. It was an amazing time. We were just so excited, so fired up. Life was good. Then we were given the concerning news that my son may be born with a heart condition. As you can imagine, our joy immediately turned to fear. Life throws you down sometimes. It was recommended that we go to Boston for a consultation. And that's when we were blessed to meet Dr. Rhodes, the difference maker. After all the testing was completed, Dr. Rhodes met with my wife and I. And the very first words he spoke to us were as follows. Let me begin by telling you how sorry I am that your son will be born with a heart condition. I've never forgotten it. His immediate kindness put me slightly at ease during such a tough time. He went on to explain to us in a very gentle manner that Colin would need 3 open heart surgeries to survive, and that the good news was that he was born at the right time. He stated that we were at the best hospital in the United States of America, and that he would be in very good hands, and my son would live a fulfilling life. Of course, we were still scared, but thanks to Dr. Rhodes' demeanor, wisdom, empathy, it gave us such hope. I am happy to say that my son is doing very well, but unfortunately, Dr. Rhodes was recently diagnosed with terminal cancer. As a result, my family wrote individual letters to express our gratitude. Considering he was my son's cardiologist, the content of Colin's letter piqued my interest. I picked up his letter, and one line in particular stood out to me, and it read as follows. Although I'm still fairly young, Dr. Rhodes, your hard work, professionalism, and compassion has already allowed me to have a meaning and fulfilling life. From someone who is both a teacher and coach, this really resonated with me. Sticks with me every day. All of Dr. Rhodes' professional and academic achievements were aimed at one thing alone. That is to improve the quality of life for others. That is when you know someone is truly selfless. When they aim to be successful, not simply for their own benefit, but for the well-being of others. I share this story with you because my wish for each one of you is that you find your meaningful path in life. I truly believe that no matter what road life takes you down, that if you can find ways to empathize and show kindness to those who cross your path, like Dr. Jonathan Rhodes did for my family, that great success will follow you no matter where you go. Remember, people will forget what you said to them, but they will never forget how they made you feel. With that being said, right now, I would like to finish with a poem that is between me and the 200, I'm gonna round it out, 280 graduates in here. We'll be optimistic. And I think you'll appreciate the rest of you in the stands. There's some meaning behind the poem. You might catch on to some of it. I know it's late in the evening, but this is from me to all you graduates. I think you'll appreciate it. And it's titled, The Great Alaskan Shootout. Here we go. Tonight, start your next step in life. Be proud. Step up. Take your shot. It's the Great Alaskan Shootout. Although it's just a game in a shrine, you know a UCLA is on the line. So blow the whistle, Frazier. Quit rambling on. Crank up the music. Game on. The Great Alaskan Shootout puts you on a team with strangers. To win takes leadership with positive energy. You see, like in life, it is more about your character than it is your skill, personality and work ethic, and how about your will? Oh no! We just got beat in Anchorage, Alaska! We all have to experience the bottom of the mountain. The humble pie hurts. It gives us direction. No pointing fingers. Get up off the canvas. Enthusiasm and focus made a difference the second time around. We got it together and learned from stepping down. No doubting, no blame. We took our lumps. Now we are back at the money basket, ready to trounce. The whistle blows. Game over. Turn off the music and bring it together to the class of 2022, 280 strong. Trust me when I say you all belong. Our time in the shrine, well, it's been mighty fine. So many relationships to last a lifetime. Did you think I actually forgot? The cages, time to hit the rock. I appreciate all of you. You will never know. I leave you with one last thing as I go. Treat each other with kindness and respect. Help those who are less fortunate, and that equals success. Congratulations to the class of 2022. I'm gonna miss you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Coach Frazier. Members of the Board of Education, as principal of Queensbury High School, I certify that the following students have fulfilled all of the requirements of the Queensbury Union Free School District and the State of New York and are eligible to receive their high school diplomas. It is my pleasure to present to you the class of 2022. Assisting with the presentation of diplomas will be Andrew Snide, Assistant Principal, Colleen Sprague, School Counselor, Superintendent Gannon, and members of the Board of Education. Would the first row please stand?
It is now my pleasure to introduce the class of 2022.
Alexandria Claire Murray. Annabelle Duran Trowbridge. Jude M.R. Jordy Donnelly. Julia Elizabeth Afsar Kashmiri. Isabella Maria Robleski. Rachel Beth Collins Mannix. Lauren Michelle Nelson. Jack E. Sturman. Lindsay Nora Bauer. Madeline Carol McEachran. Catherine Teresa McDermott. John Hicks. Kate M. Allen. Hunter J. Affinito. Aliza Afzal. Krissa Catherine Alden. Matthew C. Amash. Kylie F. Apple. Nevea Sky Arena. Dylan G. Ball. John Evan Balua. Joshua J. Barden. Karis Ella Bartlett. Gavin Dane Barton. Madonna Rose Bain. Anna Louise Bearer. Christina J. Bian. Jocelyn S. Bian. Anthony M. Belair. Haley Benware. Gage M. Berube. Miriam Elizabeth Blankenship. Aiden M. Blibtree. Christina Bolanowska. Casey Leah Bonesteel. Gina Marie Bonesteel. Angelina Giselle Bongiorno. Halise Boskirk. Chloe Renee Brialt. Elsie J. Breen. Matthew J. Brewer. Riley A. Brott. Becca Lynn Bro. Parker Brooks. Sadie J. Brown. Stephanie Lydia Sharon Brown. Luke Stephen Buckingham. Kennedy Birch. Caitlin Marie Berger. Aaron W. Butler. Claudia Renee Colby. Henry J. Campopiano. Andrew J. Canavan. Joseph Kyle Caradana. Lily Carbati. Sergio Castolo Jr. Dorin Chang. Lucas Xavier Chenier. Sophia J. Chapa. Austin W. Clements. Brian D. Collins. Daniel T. Collins. Justin J. Cologne. Abigail Lynn Comiskey. Jordan Lindsay Conine. Daniel M. Conway. Jack Paul Conway. Andrew T. Cooper. James Pearson Cornell. Brandon John Coulter. Madeline Paige Cox. Noah R. Crandall. Natalie Monroe Dijon. Adriana Nicole Delabella. Andrew M. Del Signor. Matthew J. DeSocio. Stephen Charles Deutsch. Benjamin P. Dickinson. Peyton Amelia Dickinson. Kirsten Lee Dingman. Alexandra N. DiStefano. Caitlin E. Donald. Jack L. Donaldson. Delaney M. Donahue. Sebastian Patrick Duchowski. Tyler Joseph Duell. Bridget Ann Duffy. Allison Michaela Eicher. Nathan G. Engel. Elena Estrada Torres. Casey T. Finnegan. Ryan Matthew Fosco. Austin Donald Frank. Chase A. Freed. Zion I. Freeman. Nathan E. Fuss. Cheyenne M. Garney. Caroline E. Geralds. Mackenzie M. Gerchens. Joseph M. Goodspeed Capone. Sharika S. Gordon. Camden Robert Green. Garrett W. Greenwood. Lorena Elaine Gay. DeAndre Malik Gennard. Adam R. Hashem. Olivia Haley. Avery Huntington Halliday. Broderick M. Hamilton. Rebecca Lynn Hamilton. Caden G. Hanley. Jubilee Michelle Harmon. Tyler M. Harrington. Riley Patrick Harris Burke. Levi Allen Harwood Jr. Ariana Nicole Hayes. Elena Cecile Hayward. Jacqueline D. Hendry. Nicole G. Hogan. Brandon John Holcomb. Daryl John Horick. Casey B. Howard. Terry W. Ide. Daniel T. Irwin. Drew A. Jackson. Ivan Rodney James. Troy Kelly James. Maxwell Drakowski. Marquay Rasan Johnson. Jacob L. Johnston. Alyssa Jones. Liam O. Jones. Chelsea R. Kaiser. Dylan Anthony Kay. McKenna Jane Keys. Michael J. Kilgallen. Dylan Charles Leonard Kindrun. Brett S. Kaczynski. David Kuzmiak. Kyle Joseph Lajeunesse. Ethan M. Langford. Jason A. LaPelle. Madeline Lasarso. Madison M. Lever. Brandon J. Lemery. Emma R. Lemery. Alexandria M. Lent. Lauren Linehan. Sarah Ann Little. Nicholas R. Lavote. Lorelei Amanda Lorador. Lucas Signorino Longitano. Alexis Lord. Vincent Anthony Macarulo. Briar D. McGee. John A. Mahaney. Sudipta Maitra. Krista Essence Maldonado. Christina G. Mannix. Coral Aurelia Marcantonio. Anna Elizabeth Marshall. Olivia Constance McCormick. Alexa May McCurry. Peyton Elizabeth Mahalik. Carly Grace Merzig. Karina Myers. Ashley Elizabeth Miller. Scott A. Miller. Joshua Michael Millington. Olivia C. Mansour. Julia Flevi Monturi. Trevor A. Moon. Aiden M. Mulcahy. Samantha A. Mulcahy. Camden N. Murphy. Jessica Ann Elizabeth Murray. Rachel Marie O'Connor. Kendra Starr Ogden. Sydney Nicole O'Leary. Brody M. Otruba. Samuel James Palmer. Tyler A. Palmer. Jocelyn Pape. Brittany Ann Persuti. Devin Tyler Planty. Cameron J. Poluncy. Cassandra May Potter. Lily Victory Polvac. Lucas Gabriel Powell. Blake T. Powers. William S. Pratt. Emily Lynn Racine. Kelly Lynn Ramsey. Cassidy Summer Ray. Mackenzie Joe Riley. Jenna Elizabeth Reppenhagen. Wesley E. Rhodes. Avery Rebo. Benjamin T. Robinson. Tiffany Rock. Bianca Jean Yvette Rodriguez. Alexis J. Rogers. Braden Matthew Ruby. Patrick Kieran Russell. Josiah Nathan Sanabria. Jason Nicholas Sankey Jr. Sarah E. Sassaman. Dylan B. Shell. Anna Elizabeth Schuett. Sean A. Seeley. Braden L. Shattuck. Naeem A. Sheik. Samuel D. B. Shettlewood. Michael Richard Sims. Emma Jean Slupik. Leela A. Smith. Logan J. Smith. Taylor B. Smith. Xandria Lee Smith. Campbell S. Snow. Lucas Michael Spire. Emma Frances Sponzo. Dylan Nicholas Stelly. Mackenzie Jade Steves. Janae Clemencia Stewart. Oliver Thomas Stolarik. Britta R. Stone. Joseph D. Sumner. Alexander C. Sweet. Bailey Everett Sweetser. Anthony Miles Tatum. Alexander F. Testani. Alana Thacker. Andrew J. Thatcher. Derek Stephen Thompson. Braden W. Timms. Adam N. Tobias. Ayla Tuamela. Milo V. Tverdik. Dawn Marie Uline. Giovanni Michael Vanderveer. Syria Vincenti. Caitlin D. Wadsworth. Noah R. Walters. Jacqueline Ward. Rin A. Warnecki. Kenneth S. Way. Audrey L. Welsing. Zachary M. Whalen. Austin Daniel Williams. Nicolette Willette. Jordan Mackenzie Willis. Brianna M. Winch. Mackenzie L. Yeager. Peyton H. Zahn. And congratulations to the class of 2022.
Let's try that again. Members of the Board of Education and the community of Queensbury, I am extremely proud to present to you the Queensbury High School Class of 2022. Please join me in another round of applause. Now it's time for the declaration, and I invite Superintendent Gannon to do the honors.
Will the class of 2022 please stand? Would you all please transfer the tassel on your cap from the right side to the left side? Pursuant to the authority vested in me, I declare the members of the class of 2022 to be graduates of Queensbury High School. Congratulations.
Well done. Well done, class of 2022. This brings a close to our graduation program. Thank you for being here to celebrate and participate in the commencement exercises of the Queensbury High School Class of 2022. Would all members of the audience please remain seated during the recessional until all of our graduates have exited the floor and exited the building. Thank you, good luck, and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.